我们请一起低头同心默祷。
Let's hold our hand and pray in silence.
阿门
，Amen。
哈利路亚，奉主圣名啊，继续我们晚上的聚会。
Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we shall continue with our evening service。
好，我们请一起唱诗516首。
Let's sing hymn 516。
坐。
Please be seated。
好，我们现在要一起同心跪下来祷告。
Now we're going to kneel down and pray in one accord。
那我们轻松，从今天早上到现在，我们已经一整天的聚会了哈。
From this morning till now, we have had a whole day of services。
好，所以我们可能身体上已经感觉到疲倦了。
So we may be exhausted。
但是我们既然还留在这里啊。
But since we're still here。
就求主耶稣让我们不要浪费掉我们在这里的机会跟时间。
We pray to our Lord Jesus Christ that we will not waste time and the opportunity here。
所以我们祷告求主耶稣给我们好的精神啊。
So we pray that God will strengthen us and give us good spirit.
身体虽然疲倦，
even though we are exhausted physically,
但是求主耶稣让我们聚会的时候能够专心。
Let us also pray that we can concentrate during service.
能够有真正的学习哦。
That we will have true learning.
我们一起同心跪下来祷告。
Let's all kneel down and pray in one accord.
Hallelujah. 奉主是圣名，我们继续从会幕来看信仰的人生哦。
Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we shall continue to look at a life of the tabernacle.
我们今天下午的时候，我们看了一下会幕所建设所建立的方法。
This afternoon, we talk about how the tabernacle was built.
我们谈到这个会幕基本上是用一幅又一幅的幔子把它连接起来哦。
And we have learned this afternoon that it is joined together by a series of curtains.
那这个幔子每幅都一样。
And each curtain is the same.
并且彼此能相连。
And they are connected to each other.
如同今天信徒身份都一样。
It is almost as though that we all have the same status.
并且彼此联合建立主的教会。
And we together are connected and to establish the body of Christ.
我们谈到这个会幕上面有顶盖。
And we also talk about the top of the tent.
这个顶盖里面是有染血染红的公羊皮啊。
And beneath the top, is the goat skin.That had been died.
所以一个信仰，一个教会，最后是要仰望主耶稣宝血的救恩。
So the purpose of the church is to behold the redemptive plan of our Lord Jesus Christ.
如果寻找信仰到最后没有看见宝血。
And if after pursuing our faith, we have yet to see the precious blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
如果寻找信仰，最后没有想到永生得救。
And if we have sought after the precious blood of our Lord Jesus Christ without attaining the ultimate redemption.
这种追求是没有意义的，哦。
Then this pursuit is worthless.
所以信仰追求就是要看见染血的公羊皮。
That is why the goal of our pursuit of our faith is to see the goat skin that had been dyed red.
教会的尊贵在于耶稣基督的牺牲。
The preciousness of the church lies in the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus Christ.
但是这个染血的公羊皮，你没有办法马上看见它的啊。
But you cannot immediately see the goat skin that had been dyed red.
因为它外面还罩着一层的海狗皮啊。
Outside of it is covered by badger skin.
所以啊，如同基督耶稣没有加行美容一样。
And just as our Lord Jesus Christ didn't have becoming looks.
有时候教会里面也看不到什么值得人称赞，或者是让人耳目一新了不起的大成就哦。
We do not see much worldly accomplishments within church that's worthy of our praise.
如同使徒教会啊，我们今天信徒里面大家都是很平常的普通人呢。
Just as the apostolic church, we today in the church are all ordinary people.
我们当中没有什么哇世界知名的人物。
We don't have world-renowned people among us.
我们没有是美国最大的教堂。
We don't have the biggest church in the United States.
但是寻找信仰 不是在看这些东西。
But the pursuit of our faith should not be limited to these things.
所以你今天看教会。
So today, when we assess the church,
请问你看见了什么？
What do you see?
你是只有看见外面那一层海狗皮，觉得哎呀，这个教会没什么。
Do you only see the badger skin that covers the tabernacle and think that this church has nothing to offer?
还是你看到海狗皮底下那染红的公羊皮，给你得救的真恩呢？
Or are you able to penetrate through the surface and to see the gold skin that have been dyed red, which represents the redemption of our Lord Jesus Christ.
我们继续往下看、哦、
Let's continue this passage.
我们翻到出埃及记的第三十六章。
Let's return to Exodus 36.
出埃及记三十六章的第二十节。
Verse 20.
出埃及记的三十六章二十节。
Verse 20.
他用皂荚木做帐幕的竖板二十一。
21.
每块长十轴，宽一轴半。我们再看第三十一节。
31.
他用皂荚木做栓，为这帐幕的面的板做五栓。我们再看第三十七章第一节。
Chapter 37, verse 1.
三十七章第一节，比撒列用皂荚木做柜，高两轴半，宽一轴半，高一轴半。第二节。
2.
里外包上金经，四围镶上金牙边，又处四个金环，安在柜的四角上。哈，我们在这里看到啊，他们在建造会幕，有一样东西不断的在出现。
We see that as they construct the tabernacle, one thing keeps recurring.
从里面的约柜到外面的祭坛，这个皂荚木不断的在出现。
From the ark to the external equipment, the material acacia wood keeps recurring.
那这个皂荚木是基本上建造会幕的最基础的的东西啊。
Acacia wood is actually the basic building material.For the tabernacle.
啊，皂荚木是什么
？What is it?
皂荚木基本上哈，如果你去查哈，它是矮树，小小的沙漠里的矮树，矮树丛哦。
Acacia wood is actually a kind of shrub that grows in the desert.
它不是长得很高。
It is not very tall.
它也不是长得很美。
It is not very pretty.
它没有办法跟什么香柏木哦 ，cedar 哈，没有办法跟那个香柏木来比呀、啊。
You can compare it to the cedar.
啊，但是啊，这个皂荚木却是拿来做圣殿，拿来做会幕里面主要的建材啊。
But acacia wood is the main construction material for the tabernacle.
那、啊、这个皂荚木长得，这皂荚木长得不漂亮。
So acacia wood is not pretty.
它又矮矮的。
It is a very short.
但是因为是在沙漠里面长的。
But since it grows in the desert.
虽然它长得不大。
Even though it doesn't grow into a big tree.
但是它的韧性非常非常的强啊。
It is very tenacious.
那今天我们呐、啊，就好像这个皂荚木一样啊。
Today we're just like the acacia wood.
他说啊，这个信主的啊，有名望的不多啊，有身份的也不多啊。
We don't have many who are wealthy or of high status.
但是主耶稣啊，拣选我们就好像选用这个沙漠中的皂荚木一样啊。
But our Lord Jesus Christ has chosen us.As the Israelites has chosen acacia wood for the construction.
我们没有特别的了不起。
We are not very accomplished.
我们也不是啊最聪明的人。
We are not the smartest.
但是啊，神若拣选我们，我们就可以合乎主用，被他使用啊。
But if God chooses us, we will become the noble and precious vessel of God.
但是啊，要成为皂荚木是有条件的啊。
But there are qualifications to becoming.To become acacia wood.
要成为皂荚木，你的韧性要够强。
To become acacia wood, we need to be tenacious or resilient.
你要成为耐性够强，韧性够强，你必须要从艰难的环境里面长出来啊。
To be resilient enough, we need to be trained through very tough environment.
因为皂荚木的环境非常恶劣。
Because acacia wood has to go through a very difficult environment.
所以它的成长非常困难。
That is why it is difficult for it to grow.
但是结果就是它比任何的树都要更加的韧性，更加的强啊。
But as a result, it is more resilient than any other kind of material.
今天神把我们放在一些比较辛苦的环境里面。
Today, God may have placed us in very difficult situations.
我们有时候不明白啊，为什么主啊，你不是爱我的吗？为什么我的人生会遇到这些辛苦的事情？
And we will say to the Lord, 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 why do you place me in such difficult situation, even though you say that you love me?
为什么我会受苦？
Why is it that I suffer?
为什么我呼求你的时候，你没有马上帮助我？
Why is it that you not respond to my request when I pray for you?
啊，你不爱我了吗？
Don't you love me anymore?
不是主耶稣不爱我们啊。
It's not that our Lord Jesus Christ doesn't love us.
而是主耶稣对我们的人生有一个期望。
But our Lord Jesus has expectations for us in our lives.
他希望我们能够在困难的环境当中造就更强壮的属灵体魄。
He desires that we have a stronger body after being trained in very difficult environment.
有时候环境太舒服，环境太顺利哦。
Sometimes when the environment is too smooth,
看起来很好，但是孩子变得是什么？不耐压，不抗压。
We become less resilient to pressure.
然后说我们常讲新生代叫做草莓族啊。
That is why there are some people who describe younger generation as the generation of strawberries.
那为什么讲他们是草莓族？
Why are they described as strawberries?
很漂亮啊，很香啊。
They look very pretty on the outside and it smells good.
啊，但是啊，你一用力啊，吧唧它就扁了。
But when you press upon them, they are squished.
那有时候啊，我们有时候啊，都希望孩子有最安全的环境。
Oftentimes, we want to provide the safest environment for our children.
但是有时候过分的保护，使得我们的孩子变成脆弱。
But when we are overly protective, our children become weak.
我们来看一下彼得前书哦。
Let's turn to 1 Peter.
彼得前书第四章第一节
Chapter 4, verse 1.
彼得前书第四章第一节
First Peter, chapter 4, verse 1.
啊，对不起啊，彼得前书第四章的十二节哈
Verse 12.
十二节，亲爱的弟兄啊，有火炼的试验临到你们，不要以为奇怪，似是遭遇非常的事了。第十三节
，13，
倒要欢喜，因为你们是与基督一同受苦，使你们在他荣耀显现的时候也可以欢喜快乐。哈，那这里啊，彼得告诉我们哦。
Here Peter tells us,
他说啊，如果你遭遇患难了，不要觉得很奇怪啊。
Do not be surprised at painful trial.
特别还跟你讲啊，以为啊，怎么会啊，遭遇这么奇怪的事情啊
？As though something strange were happening to you.
他说啊，这个是很正常的啊。
This is the normal course event.
就是借着这种环境操练我们啊。
It is through these painful trials that we are being trained.
今天我们的环境会决定我们的力量。
Today, our environment will determine the level of our strength.
困难的环境造就强壮的身体。
Difficult environment promotes healthy body.
啊，我还记得我第一次到那个加纳教会的时候，哦。
When I first went to Ghana Church.
啊，加纳的首都哦 ，Accra 哈，那个在 Accra 的教会啊。
In this church in Accra, which is the capital of Ghana.
然后那时候他们刚好在换屋顶啊，刚好在换啊换啊把那个他们原本是那个叫什么瓦片。瓦片的那个屋顶啊，全部都扫下来哦。
So they were trying to replace their roof, so they took down all the clay shillings.
啊，所以啊，那个满地上那个教会的外面的那个走道上，全部都是破掉的瓦片啊。
So all the walkway outside of the church are full of it.
啊，所以啊，像我们要走过去啊，都穿拖鞋啊，都要慢慢走啊，因为很痛啊，那个很尖的。
And so we had to wear our flip-flops and to walk very carefully, lest we are being pierced by it.
但是啊，你看到那个非洲的小朋友打赤脚跑过来跑过去啊。
But when you look at the kids there, they would walk barefoot without any harm happening to them.
也不会痛，也没有割到，也没流血啊。
They didn't feel any pain or suffer any cuts.
因为他们的脚上的茧啊，哇，好厚一层啊。
Because they have very thick blisters. at the sole of their foot.
因为它的环境就是这个样子啊。
That's their environment.
啊，有一次啊，也是在非洲啊，我们要办圣餐礼的时候哦。
Once I was in Africa, we had Holy Communion.
啊，结果啊，他们把那个刚刚烤好的圣餐饼拿出来啊。
And they took out this bread that was just baked in the oven.
啊，他们就直接用手拿给我们啊。
And they used their hand and give it to me.
我们就直接用手去接啊。
So we took it with our bare hands.
差点把圣餐饼丢出去啊。
We almost threw the bread out.
好烫啊。
It was so hot.
诶，但是他们拿的时候一点感觉都没有啊。
But they didn't feel anything when they took it out of the oven.
环境不一样，造就不同的体魄啊。
Different environment brings out different kinds of body.
所以啊，今天神如果给我们一个很困难的环境，
so if God has given us a very difficult environment today,
不要跟神抱怨啊，不要说神不爱你啊。
Let us not complain to God that He doesn't love us.
神可能就是因为很爱你。
Maybe it's precisely because He loves us.
他对你有很高的期望。
That He has very high expectations of you.
他希望锻炼你成为更好的工人。
And He hopes to train you to become a better worker of God.
所以在约翰福音里面说哈。
That is why the Gospel of John tells us.
他说哇，那个神那个结果子的哈，会结果子的枝子啊，那个神都会特别给他修剪呐。
God will trim those branches that bear fruits.
他说神爱你，神要用你。
So if God loves you, He will use you.
所以他给你困难的环境锻炼你。
And that is why He gives you a very difficult environment to endure in.
我们来看一下雅歌哦。
Let's turn to the Song of Songs.
我们看雅歌的第二章。
Chapter 2.
雅歌第二章的第一节哦。
Song of Songs, chapter 2, verse 1.
雅歌第二章第一节。
Song of Songs, chapter 2, verse 1.
那这里说，我是沙伦的玫瑰花，是谷中的百合。第二节。
2.
啊，我的佳偶在女子中，好像百合花在荆棘里呀。第一节跟第二节是不同的人讲的。
Verse 1 and 2 were spoken by different people.
第一节啊，是太太讲的。
Verse 1 was spoken by the wife.
啊，就是你跟我啦，主耶稣的心腹啊。
Which is you and me, who are the bride of Christ.
我们都希望做沙伦的玫瑰。
We all want to be a rose of Sharon.
啊，沙伦他基本上是个沙地哈，就是那个土地上基本上啊，种那里种很多玫瑰，但是主要是沙地。
So the place of Sharon is actually a sandy place.
哦，所以啊，那个地方啊，它的玫瑰基本上是靠天下雨。
And so for a rose to grow, it requires rain from heaven.
下雨，那个玫瑰就长得很漂亮。
When there's rain, then the rose grows well.
我们都希望做沙伦的玫瑰啊。
We all hope to be a rose of Sharon.
主啊，我渴慕你的恩典。
Oh Lord, I long for your grace.
主啊，主啊，你的恩典丰丰富富浇灌在我的生命当中。
Oh Lord, may your abundant blessings be showered upon me.
我们都想做谷中的百合。
We all want to be a lily of the valley.
神的膀臂如同山谷，环抱我们，保护我们。
And we wish that the deep embrace of our Lord Jesus Christ is just like the mountains that surround us.
啊，让我在里面啊，漂漂亮亮的长大啊。
So that I can grow up in this protected environment.
那这个是我们对常常我们的期望。
This is often our hope.
但是你看啊，我们的天父他的期望是什么？
But look at the expectation of our heavenly Father.
在这里啊，新郎说哈，我的佳偶好像百合花在荆棘里啊。
Here the lover or the husband says, like a lily among thorns is my darling among the maidens.
我们想要在谷中啊，有主耶稣常常保护着就好了。
We often want to be protected within the valley.
但是主要我们在荆棘当中仍然能够变成百合。
But even among thorns, we can still be like a lily.
这个是神对我们的心意啊。
This is God's intention for us.
能够成为沙漠中的皂荚木。
That we become the acacia wood in the desert.
困难的环境能够造就我们忍耐到底的信仰。
Difficult environment will become conducive to our growth in faith.
但是我们这里看到啊，在约柜当中或在会幕里面，这个皂荚木要包金哦。
But let us also notice that this acacia wood needs to be enclosed in gold.
我们看到他做约柜、做杠子都是皂荚木包金块啊，包金条哦。
And so each component of the ark is made of acacia wood that is encased in gold.
什么叫做包金子啊?
What does it mean to be overlaid with gold?
包金子就是我们的侍奉是荣耀的，是有价值的。
It means that our service is meaningful and is full of value.
我们来看一下哥林多后书的第四章啊。
Let's turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 4.
哥林多后书的第四章。
2 Corinthians chapter 4.
哥林后书第四章的第七节啊
，verse 7，
第七节
，verse 7，
他说：“我们有这宝贝放在瓦器里，要显明这莫大的能力是出于神，不是出于我们自己啊。”这里呀、啊，讲说啊，瓦器啊，瓦器不值钱啊。
This verse mentions jars of clay, which is not worth a lot.
瓦器很脆弱啊。
Jars of clay.
所以在旧约啊，如果瓦器脏了瓦器污秽就直接打破啊。
Are very fragile. So in the olden days, when they are defiled, they are just being broken.
有的东西啊，弄脏了洗一洗啊，瓦器弄脏就把它打破啊。
For other things, you may wash them, but in terms of jars of clay, you just destroy them once they are defiled.
因为瓦器不值钱，瓦器很脆弱。
Jars of clay are worthless.
但是啊，这里说啊，我们就好像这个瓦器一样哦。
But we are just like the jars of clay.
我们没有什么特别，没有什么特别厉害的。
We don't have anything special about us.
但是因为有神在我们的生命当中。
But it is precisely because God is in our midst.
所以我们就成为有宝贝的瓦器，就能显明莫大的荣耀啊。
Then we have this treasure in jars of clay to show that all the surpassing power is from God and not from us.
你跟我，我们就是瓦器啊。
You and I are all jars of clay.
脆弱而无用。
We are useless.And fragile.
但是我们今天生命当中有神的圣灵。
But today we have the Holy Spirit.
所以我们能够做世界上最有价值的工作。
And that is why we're able to do the most precious and meaningful thing in this world.
就是借着你跟我，使人看见耶稣，能够寻到真理。
Which is through us, others can see Jesus in us and receive the truth.
有比这个更大的荣耀吗？
Is there any greater glory than this?
有比这更有价值的工作吗？
Is there anything more meaningful than this?
所以啊，宝贝放在我们这个瓦器里面。
That is why this treasure had been placed in this jar of clay of ours.
如同皂荚木外面包金金一样啊。
It is just like the acacia wood that had been overlaid with pure gold.
无用的皂荚木变成圣所中圣的器皿。
So the acacia wood that was not worth very much now becomes a precious instrument in the household of God.
所以我们今天的侍奉是有荣耀的。
So today our service carries with it much glory.
我们今天参与圣工是有价值的。
It is valuable for us to participate in the ministry.
但是我们不要忘记一件事情。
But let us not forget one thing.
我们不要忘记本质里面我们只是皂荚木啊。
Let us never forget that the essence that we have is that we are merely acacia wood.
有时候坐久了以为哎呀我是黄金做的啊。
Sometimes after we serve for a long time, we mistakenly thought we are overlaid with pure gold.
我的意见就是神的旨意。
My will is the will of God.
我的想法就是教会的方向。
My thinking is the direction of the church.
反对我的就是对抗耶稣，对抗神啊。
Anyone who opposes me opposes God.
这种话不要乱讲哦。
Never say such things.
如果讲这种话，表示你忘记你是皂荚木啦。
If you think that way, you have already forgotten you are made of acacia wood.
你以为你是黄金做的啊
？You thought that you are made of gold.
我们不要随便说，我们不要讲什么我的旨意。你如果跟我意见不同，你就是违背神的旨意啊。这种话是不能讲的、啊。
So let us never look that highly upon our own material.Opinion that when others' opinions are different, we would disregard them.
如果我们讲这种话是什么意思？
And if we make such comments, what does it actually mean?
这句话的意思代表我就是我的神呐、啊。
It means that I am my own God.
所以你跟我意见不同，你就是违背神呐、啊，违背我这个神呐、啊。
And that is why if you disagree with me, you are disagreeing with me, which is God in my own eyes.
我们怎么知道神的旨意到底是什么？
How do we know what God's will is?
我们难道真的有把握我的想法就是神的意见吗？
Do we have full confidence that whatever we think is the will of God?
你的意见，你的想法可能是最好的。
Perhaps your opinion is really the best.
你的提案，你的方法可能是最在当下最好的解决方法。
Perhaps your proposal or your method is really the best way possible at this present moment.
但是对的方法不代表正确的时间啊。
But just because it is the right thing to do doesn't mean that it is done at the right time.
你的好方法可能甚至最错误的时间啊。
The good method that you have devised may be done at the worst time.
所以我们真的不知道啊。
So we don't really know.
我们可以提出我们的想法跟我们的意见。
We may raise our opinion.
但是不要以为我的想法绝对就是神的方法啊。
But never think that whatever you say is the will of God.
所以皂荚木的价值在包金子。
So the value of the acacia wood is in the gold that is overlaid over it.
但是千万不要忘记，本质上我们也就是卑贱的皂荚木啊。
But in essence, we are just the humble acacia wood.
所以有一个同工常常分享一句话啊。
So a co-worker of mine often shares with me.
他很喜欢讲这句话，我很喜欢听啊。
And I love to hear this.
他常常讲说，我们是伟大的使命，不伟大的自己啊。
He always says that we are the unworthy self, taking on the most precious mission.
这句话真的是要反映到我们每一个人侍奉的生命的最深处啊。
And this statement really reflects the innermost value of our service to God.
能侍奉是种荣耀，因为你被包金子了。
To be able to serve is a kind of glory because we have been overlaid with pure gold.
但是不要在侍奉恩典当中忘记自己是谁啊。
But let us never forget who we really are, even when we are under the grace of His blessings.
我就是沙漠中的皂荚木。
We are just the acacia wood in the desert.
是便宜的。
We are cheap.
真的，皂荚木不值钱啊。
Acacia wood is not worth very much.
但是被神所用就有了价值啊。
But when we are used by God, we have value.
所以我们大家都要做皂荚木包金。
So we should all be acacia wood that's overlaid with pure gold.
我们看回来出埃及记啊。
Let's return to Exodus.
我们看回来出埃及记的第三十八章。
Exodus chapter 38.
二十九节。
Verse 29.
三十八章的第二十九节。
Exodus chapter 38, verse 29.
那这里说，又按做香之法做圣膏油和馨香料的馨香，三十七章，对不起，三十七章的二十九节哦。
Sorry, it's 37 verse 29.
出埃及记的第三十七章的第二十九节。
Exodus chapter 37 verse 29.
那这里说，又要按做香之法做圣膏油跟馨香料的馨香，哈，那这里啊，他们有一个香炉啊，要烧香给神呢。
Here they have,
incense.
They have the altar of incense.
所以他们必须要做香料拿来烧给神闻哦。
And so they must make, the pure fragrant incense and burn it for God.
那这里啊，这个做香料它有很特殊的要求跟规矩。
And there are very strict rules and regulations as to how they would produce such incense.
我们来看一下出埃及记的第三十章哈。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 30.
三十章的第三十四节。
Verse 34.
出埃及记的第三十章第三十四节。
Exodus 30, verse 34.
这里神吩咐摩西说，你要取馨香的香料，就是拿他佛、施洗列、洗利比拿，这馨香的香料和净乳香，各样要一般大的分量，三十五。
35.
你要用这些加上盐，按做香之法做成清净圣洁的香，这香要取点捣得极细，放在会幕内法会前，我要在那里与你相会，你们都要以这香为至圣。三十七。
37.
你们不可按这调和之法为自己做香，要以这香为圣，归神。三十八。
38.
凡做香的和这香一样，为要闻香味的，这人要从民中剪除。所以在这里讲到啊，要做这个香料来烧香给神哦。
And here are instructions as to how they will make this incense to be offered to God.
那他们在讲到这里哦，有规定一定要用什么方法来做。
And they are very specific as to how they will make such incense.
什么原料？
What kind of material?
分量多少？
the proportions,
制作方法,
and also the way to make it,
都有直接而且清楚的交代啊。
There are very clear instructions.
所以我们今天在侍奉神，如同在烧香一样。
So today, our service to God is just like making such incense.
不是你爱怎么调。爱怎么做就怎么做的、
啊。We don't do it whichever way we feel like it.
侍奉是有规矩的。
There are rules to our service.
教会是有组织的。
The church has its organization.
这个圣工必须要有计划的。
And our holy work must be done systematically.
不能够说我爱怎么做就怎么做。
We can't just do it haphazardly.
啊，在这里讲说啊，每一样东西的分量多少都是有规定啊。
And here it even tells us that all kinds of materials are all done with in equal amounts.
而且啊，要拿到神面前来用，他说你要捣得极碎啊。
And here says that you must bring all these things before the presence of the Lord and
把它捣到极碎哈、哦，36节哈、哦、，grind it 哈、
哦。You should also grind some of it to powder.
哦，说啊，要把它捣到很碎，才能拿来神的面前啊。
And only then can you place it before God.
让他看不出来它原本的形状。
So that they would not see its original shape.
所以我们今天侍奉神啊，也是要把自己捣得极碎啊。
So today, as we serve God, we also need to grind ourselves.
很多时候我们做事情都有自己的一套方法啊。
Oftentimes we have our own way of doing things.
有时候我们觉得啊，你要我做就是照我的方法啊。
Oftentimes So we'll say that if you want to do a certain thing, you must do it my way.
啊，不照我的方法，对不起，我不做哈。
If you don't do it my way, I'm not going to do it.
啊，所以有一次啊，我们请一个青年啊，来帮忙学生联谊会哦。
So once we asked a youth to come and help with a spiritual convocation.
那这个青年非常有恩赐。
This youth is very talented.
啊，但是啊，当我们请他来帮忙的时候
，But when we ask him to help,
他说啊，要帮忙可以。照我的方法
，He said, "I'm going to do it only if I do it my way."
你不照我的方法，那就 forget it， 我才不要的。
If you don't do it my way, forget it.
啊，所以教会就跟他说哦
，So the church told him，
说这样子啊，谢谢不用了。
Thank you, that's okay.
啊，为什么呢
？Why？
他很有能力啊。
He was very talented.
很有恩赐啊。
He was gifted.
但是当你侍奉的心态有问题
，But when your attitude of service is wrong,
没有把自己这个捣得极碎呈在神的面前哦。
If you did not grind yourself up before God,
你就没有办法成为馨香的祭献给神了。
Then you are no longer a fragrant offering that's being offered to God.
哦，所以我们在侍奉当中啊，不要过分的坚持自己啊。
So in our service to God, let us never be too opinionated.
不要在教会里面强调我我我。
Don't keep focusing on you, your ego.
我的方法，我的智慧，我的我我就是要这样子做。
My method, my wisdom, the way that I do things.
那有时候啊，这种侍奉就呈不到神的面前了。
Otherwise, such kind of service will never be presented to God.
哦，同时在这里讲说啊，这个香。不能够做给自己闻哦。
And here it says that this incense must not be made for oneself.
那在这里说啊，做这个香要来自己闻香味的，要从民中把它剪除啊。
In fact, it says here, whoever makes any like it to enjoy its fragrance must be cut off from his people.
我们会觉得说哇，怎么这么残忍啊
？We will think, what a cruel instruction.
但是在这里啊，神是要给我们今天一个警告。
But actually, God wants us to heed this warning today.
今天做圣工，今天来教会，我们不是为了要追求自己的好处哦。
Today we come to church and we serve God not for our own benefit.
一切的侍奉当中，最后是要求荣耀归于神。
Everything that we serve, must be given to God's glory.
不要到最后做得很努力，但是想要把香味拿来自己闻一下。
Let us not work very hard and yet try to enjoy its fragrance.
所以人不要抢夺神的荣耀。
So let us never rob God of His glory.
因为抢夺神的荣耀会要付出代价的哦。
Because if we do that, we will have to pay the price.
哦，所以圣经里面告诉我们啊。
That is why the Bible tells us.
说你跟我啊，我们都只是侍奉的仆人啊。
You and I are only servants of God.
那仆人做工，难道主人还要感谢他吗
？If we are mere servants, does the Master have to thank us for all we do?
今天我们来参与圣工。
Today we participate in holy work.
我们不是为了负责人呢。
It is not so much for any of the church council members.
所以不要觉得啊，负责人你欠我一个人情哦，我帮你哦。
So don't ever think that you are doing the church council members a favor by doing something in the church.
我们今天奉献啊，不是施舍给教会耶。
Today when we offer, we are not trying to.Be charitable to the church.
哇，教会好可怜啊！最近没有钱，来给你五块啊
！Oh, the church is so pitiful. Let me give you $5.
那这种都是观念，都是有问题啊
If you think that way, you are misguided.
不要觉得说啊，那个负责人欠你的啊，教会欠你的啊。
Don't think that the church or the council members owe you anything.
奉献是恩典，能够参与圣工叫福气哦。
To be able to offer.Is a grace to you, and to be able to work for church is also a blessing of God.
哦，所以不要说啊，我奉献比较多，我可以讲话比较大声啊，没有这种事情啊。
So then, don't ever think that if you offer more, you have more say in the ministry.
那其实啊，我们在奉献的事情上啊，要有正确的观念哦。
In fact, in terms of offering, we need to hold the right attitude.
啊，能够奉献叫做报答主的恩典啊。
We offer to repay.The grace of God.
其实你想想啊，哪有比这个更好的事情啊
？Think about it. There's no better thing than offering to God.
你说你奉献吗
？So let's say you offer something to God.
奉献十一捐，奉献感恩捐哦。
Let's say you offer tithe.
请问主耶稣有没有给你收走啊？主耶稣有没有来被你收走啊？
Did Jesus actually come and collect it?
主耶稣有没有每个礼拜六下午啊过来检查一下奉献箱啊，看今天多少钱啊
？Did Jesus?Ever personally come and check on you to see if you really offer tithes?
请问你奉献的钱都去哪里了
？Where does your money go?
这个电灯要不要钱
？Think about
电费要不要钱啊
？Our utility bills.
啊，这个电费，这个电灯是给谁照啊
？Who are these lights on for?
啊，有照到主耶稣吗
？That
应该也是没有吧
？Does our Lord Jesus need the lights?
啊，那个中午啊，爱餐是谁在吃啊？
How about our Thanksgiving meal over lunch?
主耶稣没来跟我们一起吃啊。
Did Jesus come and eat it with us?
通通被你跟我吃掉啦。
We ate it.
哦，所以啊，你想想看哦，奉献是啦，你是奉献给教会啦。
It is true that you offer it to the church.
水电瓦斯都是被我们用掉的。
But we use up all the utilities.
爱餐都是被我们吃掉的。
And we ate all the Thanksgiving meals.
所以啊，你奉献最后钱都用在你自己身上啊。
So as you offer, you are actually benefiting.
啊！结果主耶稣还说：“你奉献，我要从天上赐福给你啊
！”And yet our Lord Jesus promises that as long as we offer to Him, He will pour down His blessings from heaven.
有这么好的地哦，你不要，那你要什么
？If you neglect such a great deal, what else do you want?
你把钱拿出来，再把它吃掉，然后天上再降福气给你。
You offer the money, you benefit from it, and you are going to get blessings from heaven.
啊，你为什么不要呢
？Why don't you？
啊，所以啊，我们今天在侍奉的道路上面哦。
So in our service.
那记得啊，我们侍奉啊，是为了教会，为了神啊。
Let us remember that we are doing it for God and for the church.
我们今天奉献呐，花我们的时间或我们的金钱。
Today, when we offer our strength, our service, and our money,
是一种感恩啊，主啊，感谢你，我有机会能够参与啊。
It is a way to show our gratitude that we're able to participate in his ministry.
因为能够参与本身就是一种福气。
Because by virtue of participating in the ministry, it itself is a blessing.
哦，所以在这里说啊，你做香哦，不要自己闻呐。
So when you make that fragrance, never enjoy its fragrance.
你侍奉啊，不要一直求人家给你拍拍手啊。
So never ask for applause as you serve God.
啊，我有一次遇到一个弟兄，一个年轻人哦。
Once I met a very young brother.
他跟我说啊，讲的还蛮有，还啊，讲的很大声哦。
He told me with full confidence.
他说啊，我的恩赐就是做台前的服事。
My gift is to serve on the pulpit.
他说，你看到我这个手吗？
Look at my hand.
他说我是弹钢琴的手。
Look, I can play the piano.
不可以叫我去洗碗。
Don't ever assign me to wash dishes.
我的恩赐啊，就是做那个给大家看见的啊。
My gift is to do things that people can see.
哎，真的啊，有时候啊，人会有这种想法哦。
sometimes we harbor these thoughts.
喜欢啊，做那些别人看得见的啊。
We like to do things that are visible.
想要做那些啊，能够得到人掌声的啊。
We like to do things that will garner applause from people.
啊，这样子实在是不好哦。
This is not good.
啊，所以啊，今天在教会里面啊，不管神所托付我们的是什么样的使命。
That is why whatever task that God has assigned us today.
或者是在台前的服事。
Whether it be on the pulpit,
或者是在幕后的努力
or behind the scene,
啊都没有关系啊，主看见，主给你拍拍手啊。
It doesn't matter. As long as God sees all that you do, He will applaud.
只要一个人有心用心服事，就是有价值的啊。
As long as we serve Him with all our heart, our service is valuable.
只要一个人有心啊，神就会给予能力，给予帮助哦。
As long as we have the heart, God will help us.
所以不要求自己的荣耀。
So never serve.To glorify yourself.
在我们努力侍奉之后，哦
After we serve with all our might,
只是说啊，我是无用的仆人啊。
All we can say is that we are the unworthy servant.
主啊，你给我这个机会服事，感谢你啊。
Oh Lord, thank you for giving me this opportunity to serve.
这样你的工作就有了价值。
Then your service is valuable.
这样子你所流的汗水就被神所纪念啊。
Then your sweat.For that service will be remembered by God.
我们看回来哦，我们看回来的第三十八章哦。
Exodus 38.
出埃及记的第三十八章。
Exodus 38.
啊，我们看三十章哦。等一下再来三十八章，先看一下出埃及记的第三十章。
Exodus chapter 30.
十七节
，verse 17。
出埃及记的第三十章的第十七节啊、哦、
，Exodus 30 verse 17。
啊，这里说神晓谕摩西说什么？你要用铜做洗涤盆和盆座，以便洗涤。要将盆放在会幕和坛的中间，在盆里盛水十九。
19.
亚伦和他的儿子要在这个盆里洗手洗脚二十。
20.
他们进会幕或是就近坛前供职给神献火祭的时候，必用水洗涤，免得死亡。21节。
21.
他们洗手洗脚就免得死亡，这要做亚伦和他后代后裔世世代代永远的定例啊、哦。那这里讲到有一样东西叫做洗涤盆呢、啊。
There's something called the basin for washing.
他说这个啊，洗涤盆啊，就是啊，让祭司洗手洗脚的。
The basin for washing is used by the priests to wash their limbs.
他说啊，如果没有洗啊，到神的面前不洁净啊，可能会死掉哦。
If they do not wash their hands and feet, they may die.
那所以，因为我们今天侍奉是要一个洁净的，要有一个洁净的工作。
And so today we need to go through a cleansing process to serve God.
哦，所以啊，神特别吩咐我，任何人要到会幕前，要到神面前，要洗手洗脚，以成洁净啊。
And that is why God wants us to wash our hands and feet with water, so that we can enter into the tent of meeting.
我们今天参与的是圣工。
Today we participate.In holy work,
啊，不是外面任何世界上的工作啊。
It is not any other kind of work in this world.
既然圣工，就要求你成圣啊。
Since we are doing holy work, we need to be holy.
我们必须要先学会洁净自己，才能够参与侍奉啊。
We need to know how to cleanse ourselves before we can serve God.
你看，当神选召摩西的时候。
When God chose Moses,
啊，摩西跑过来了啊，看到那个荆棘啊，在火里面在烧啊。
Moses came and saw the burning bush.
啊，结果他就跑过来啦。
So he came over.
结果神的声音对摩西说什么
？And the voice of the Lord said to him.
他有没有跟摩西说，摩西呀、啊，哎，准备出发，准备行大神迹呀、啊？
Did God immediately tell him to go out and to perform great miracles?
没有啊，神第一件事对他说啊，脱下你脚上的鞋啊。
No, the very first thing that God told him was to Take his sandals.
因为你所在的地方是圣的。
Because where he stood was holy ground.
当约书亚带领以色列百姓要攻进迦南啊。
When Joshua led the Israelites to attack the land of Canaan.
他正在看耶利哥城，城墙高大，要怎么打他呢
？He looked at the strong, forts of the city of Jericho and thought about how to attack it.
结果这个时候，神的使者来了。
Then the angel of the Lord came.
约书亚马上俯伏下拜说：“主啊，有什么吩咐啊？”
Joshua immediately fell prostrate and asked the Lord what kind of instructions he has for him.
约书亚可能在期望说、啊、天使要告诉他哇怎么打从哪里可以这样打进去可以成功啊。
Joshua might have expected the angel to instruct him how to attack the city from whichever angle with whatever strategy.
给他一些战略、哦、给他一些那个打仗的技巧啊。
And perhaps he was looking for some kind of military strategy.
结果、啊、没有啊这个神的使者第一句话说什么
But in fact, what was the very first words of the angel to Joshua?
说脱下你脚上的鞋、啊、因为你所在的地方是圣的、啊、
Take off your sandals, for where you stand is holy ground.
所以侍奉神从洗手洗脚成为洁净开始啊。
And so our service begins with washing our hands and our feet.
我们今天来参与教会的圣工，来教会侍奉神也是这样啊。
Likewise with our service.
哦、侍奉不是只有花时间花上你的努力啊
To serve God is not just to expand our time and effort
不是很忙啊看这个访问那个打电话不是只有这样子而已啊
It is not just being busy visiting people or calling people up
更重要的是那个没有人看见的时候你在背后的灵修功夫啊
But what's even more important is our cultivation that we dobehind others.
如果不没有灵修生活，没有灵修功夫的支撑
，if we do not cultivate ourselves in secret,
那有时候啊，工作越多，信仰越软弱啊。
Then the more you do, the weaker your faith becomes.
有时候啊，缺乏那个属灵认识啊，属灵灵修的功夫啊。
Sometimes we lack this effort of cultivation.
有时候忙到最后啊，什么都做，就是没洗手洗脚啊。
Sometimes we do everything except washing our hands and feet.
使得我们的努力不被神所接纳。
So that our toil is not accepted by God.
使得我们的工作没有得神的喜悦。
So that all that we do are not pleasing to God.
所以在这里啊，他特别设了一个洗涤盆哦。
That is why a basin for washing was established here.
说亚伦跟他的后裔只要接近，就是要洗手洗脚啊。
So Aaron and his descendants would have to wash their hands and feet as they approach.
有没有很麻烦
？The tent of meeting was it very troublesome?
有可能你就觉得很麻烦啊。
Yes, it may be troublesome.
但是很麻烦，你还是要做啊。
But you still have to do it.
你可以想象说，如果今天啊，你是那个祭司啊
，Just think about If you are the priest today,
你刚刚到这个、啊、才刚刚洗完手洗完脚到了那个什么会幕啊。
You just wash your hands and feet and you arrive at the tent of meeting.
啊，糟糕，要献的祭物忘了拿。
Oh, I forgot to bring the sacrifice.
啊，这到隔壁去再把它拿过来。
So you go to the next door, go next door and then take the sacrifice.
你要再洗手洗脚一次啊。
And when you come back, you still have to wash your hand and feet again.
所以灵修洁净的功夫，不要以为麻烦哦。
So never think of the effort to cultivate ourselves as tedious.
因为这会使我们免得死亡啊。
Because this would prevent us from dying.
哦，但是这个铜盆呐、啊，这个洗涤的铜盆是从哪里来？怎么做的呢
？So where did this basin for washing come from?
我们来看一下出埃及记的三十八章哦。
Let's turn to Exodus 38.
出埃及记的第三十八章第八节。
Exodus 38 verse 8.
第八节。
Verse 8.
他用铜。做洗涤盆和盆座是用会幕门口侍奉的妇人的镜子做的，哎，这是一件很奇怪的事情啊。
This is a very strange thing.
他们那个时候铜很多啊，那个到处从各个以色列家里收集来的铜很多啊。
They had collected much bronze from each household of Israel.
但是啊，这里特别吩咐说，这个铜盆哦，这个洗涤盆要用会幕前侍奉的妇人她的镜子来做啊。
But interestingly, they made the bronze basin as bronze stand from the mirrors of the women who serve at the entrance to the tent of meeting.
那个镜子，他们那个时候是铜镜啊，没有玻璃哦，用铜镜啊。
Back then, they didn't have glass, so they had bronze mirrors.
哦，所以这个镜子啊，是啊什么？妇人是女人，那个平常啊，看一看自己有没有漂亮，有没有整齐的方法哦。
And so, these bronze mirrors were.The only way that women would assess their looks.
但是啊，有那么多的铜不用， 为什么一定要用侍奉妇人的镜子呢？
So they have so much bronze, and yet they only use the bronze from the mirrors of the women who serve at the entrance to the tent of meeting.
真的是很值得我们去思考的一件事情啊。
This is really worthy of our pondering.
在那个年代啊，妇人没有，女人没有什么地位哦。
Back in those days, women didn't have any status in the society.
哦，它基本上是个父系社会，是以男人为主的。
They were in a patriarchal society.
啊，但是啊，这些妇人啊，很虔诚，很爱神哦。
But these women love the Lord.
所以他们愿意在会幕面前，会幕前面啊，做他们能做的一些侍奉的工作。
So they serve in whichever way they could at the entrance of the tent of meeting.
虽然可能做不了什么大事。
Even though they couldn't do a whole lot.
因为那个时候祭司一定是男的。
Because back then the priests have to be male.
哦，所以啊，妇人能够做的其实不多。
So the women couldn't do a whole lot.
但是啊，神看见，神特别说，我就是要用这些妇人的镜子啊。
But God saw their service and wanted to use the bronze from the mirrors of these women.
今天我们很多信徒啊，可能就是像这些妇人一样，很低调、很谦卑的服事哦。
Today we have many members who serve very humbly and very low key, like these women.
他们可能一辈子也不会有什么机会在讲台上这样子讲道。
Perhaps in their lifetime, they would never have this opportunity to preach on the pulpit.
他们可能不会被所有的人所认识。
They might not be recognized by everybody.
但是这种低调却虔诚的服事被神所看见，被神所纪念啊。
But such a low key service is noticed and remembered by God.
有时候我们在想啊，教会真正的动力到底在哪里啊？
What is a true, true motivating force in the church?
哦，是那个很会讲道的传道吗？
Is it the eloquent pastor?
还是很有能力的负责人呢？
Or the very powerful church council members?
其实我们仔细看哦，
Actually, if we look carefully,
教会的成长，教会的兴旺，常常是在那个低调又无声的普通信徒啊。
Oftentimes, the growth of the church hinges on these members who are often unsung heroes in the church.
你看啊，那个慕道者是谁带的？
Who bring these truth seekers?
是都是传道带来的吗？没有啦，传道都没有带慕道者啦。
Probably the pastors don't bring as many truth seekers as they do.
就是信徒啊，就是你们啊。
It is you.
那个教会哦，为什么能够保持得这么干净？
Why is the church so clean?
为什么每个部分都有人去负责？
Why is it that every part of the church is accounted for?
就是你们，因为你们低调却虔诚的服事啊。
It is because of you and your low-key and unnoticed service.
有的信徒啊，一放假就跑到教会来了。
There are some people who would come to church when they have time off.
跑来教会啊，倒倒垃圾啊，擦擦这个，整理整理那个啊。
They may take the trash out and clean the chapel.
有没有其他人看见？
Did anybody see you?
没有啊，没有人看见啊。
Nobody saw you.
没有人给你拍手。
Nobody applauds what you did.
你放心啊，主耶稣给你拍手啊。
But don't worry, God will applaud you.
啊，我有一天啊，晚上很晚的时候，临时到教会去拿东西啊。
One day, I went to church really late to retrieve something.
12点多啊，结果看到有一个姐妹在教会插花。
It was past midnight, but I saw a sister arranging flowers.
她说啊，因为她那天上晚班，所以下了班再赶到教会哦。
She said she took the night shift, and that is why she went to the church only after work.
结果在教会啊，插花插到快两点才回家。
And she arranged flowers until 2 a.m.
有人看见吗？没有啊，只有我看到啊。
Did anybody see her? No, just me.
有没有人给她拍手啊？有了，我有说她擦得很好啦。
Did anybody applaud what she did? Oh, of course, I complimented her.
真的，如果我那一天没有到啊，她也是就做完两点就回家啦。
If I had not arrived that day, she would have arranged flowers to till 2 a.m. and then went home.
但是她的服事神都看见了啊。
But God saw her service.
真的啊，教会里面最需要的就是会幕前侍奉的妇人啊。
What the church needs the most are the women who serve at the entrance to the tent of meeting.
所以神特别就吩咐要用他们的镜子来做这个重要的洗涤盆啊。
And that's why God wanted to use the bronze from the mirrors of the women who serve.
但是呢，在这里啊，也变成对这些妇人的一个考验哦。
But this is also a test to these women.
不要忘记，在那个年代哈，在那个年代啊，不像我们今天哦，这么的进步，这么的方便啊。
Don't ever imagine that back then, they're as advanced as we are today.
哦，所以啊，一个女生啊，可能十几、二十个镜子啊，看要几个都没有问题呀。
So these days you may have dozens and dozens of mirrors, and you can take as many as you want.
大的、小的、圆的、扁的都有啊。
Big ones, small ones, round and other shapes.
这些妇人啊，可能她就只有这么一个镜子啊。
Back then, they might only have one mirror per woman.
有铜不代表能做镜哦。
Just because you have bronze doesn't mean you can make a bronze mirror out of it.
它要有镜子，可能需要特别的加工，可能是它很重要而且很珍惜的啊。
In order to make a mirror out of bronze, you need to go through a special process, and that is why they treasure the bronze mirror they have.
可能是他每天要看看自己今天有没有美啊。
Perhaps it's something that they look to see whether they are pretty.
大概就只有这么一个。
So each woman may only have one mirror.
但是这时候神就说啊，我要你那个镜子啊。
But here, God wanted the bronze from their mirrors.
对，这是对他们的一个考验哦。
So this is a test from God.
要看你有没有这个舍得的心呐。
God wanted to see if they have the heart of giving.
献出你珍贵的镜子。
That they would offer their precious bronze mirror.
成就圣殿，成就会幕中圣洁的器皿啊。
Complete this basin for washing that is needed in the tent of meeting.
如果它在你身上，它永远就是一个镜子。
To you, it may only be a mirror forever.
但是你如果舍得
，But if you give it up,
拿出来为主所用。
And give it to God's use.
它就成为了尊贵的器皿。
Then it becomes a precious vessel.
并且在世世代代为人为神所纪念。
And it will be remembered by man and God for generations to come.
所以今天神也要我们有一个舍得的心呐。
So today God wants us to have the heart of giving.
神向我们要的不多。
God doesn't demand very much from us.
但是你愿意吗
？But are you willing?
我们一起来唱诗哈。
Let's sing him.
我们唱诗396首。
Let's sing him 396.
感谢主耶稣啊，我们要一起做结束的祷告。
Thank God, we're going to offer our concluding prayer.
我们感谢主耶稣带领我们今天一整天的崇拜聚会。
We thank God for His guidance for today's services.
哦，明天我们早上有洗礼啊。
We're going to have baptism tomorrow.
这个洗礼是一个人出黑暗进光明的一个关键啊。
Baptism is the crux. The main process through which we will enter into light from darkness.
我们希望把人带进神的恩典。
And we hope to bring everyone into the grace of Christ.
但是魔鬼却不愿意轻易的把人给放掉哦。
But Satan is unwilling to let go of these people.
所以这就是一场征战。
So this is a struggle.
而这场征战是需要我们每一个信徒，每一个人一起来努力的。
And this battle requires each and every one of us to work hard against.
所以我们都要为明天的洗礼来祷告。
So let us pray for tomorrow's baptism.
也求主耶稣带领我们明天的洗脚礼以及圣餐礼。
And may God also guide tomorrow's foot washing and holy communion.
能够借着每一次的灵恩会，都使我们信仰得到力量。
That through each spiritual convocation, we will be strengthened in our faith.
那我们一起同心跪下来祷告
Let's all kneel down and pray in one accord.